Welcome back. Our feature report this week takes us to Sigillo in central Italy. Tim Russon reports on the Women's World Hang Gliding Championships.
You can't really be a competitor like in tennis, for example, where it's just one-on-one and you want to beat the other one, because you're flying together until the very last thermal. So you really help each other find the thermals, and it doesn't make sense to edge, to knock with the elbows. You can't do that in the air anyway. So it's more or less flying together, and in the end, just trying to be a little bit faster.
No woman pilot flies higher than reigning champion Karina Schwiegershausen. She's chasing a record fourth crown. She's chasing hang gliding history. Sigillo in Italy is chasing a women's world championship to remember. And above the rooftops of Sigillo in Umbria stands Monte Cucu. It's always been a must-see place for every hang glider pilot. For the next few days, it's a must-be place for the world's top women flyers.
Beautiful place, plenty of space to set up the gliders, plenty of space in the air. I think it's a beautiful place, and the pizza is the best.
Oh, it's been a bit of a mecca for about 20 years. And the town is so supportive. They've set up a nice little sort of free flight establishment here. And say people say they're coming to Italy to go flying. It's either to the Alps or to Monte Cucu. It's really good. It offers a good variety of flying. And it's a great place to be.
Monte Cucu is a beautiful mountain. And we are very happy to have here the World Championship. And this year we have also a very nice day.
So everybody's happy. The sun is shining. The stage, or should we say the sky, is set for the 11th FAI Women's World Hang Gliding Championship.
We are trying to get more women interested in flying and in competition flying, because it's not really a male thing. It's also a female thing. You don't have to be strong or macho to do this sport. So, for instance, somebody who has a chance to win here, Corinna Schwiegershausen, she is a member of the German team between the male pilots. So she beats a lot of male pilots.
And what of hang gliding's very own Wonder Woman, Corinna Schwiegershausen, winner of the last three world championships? Victory here would take her into the record books. Her secret?
Flying as much as you can, really enjoying the flying, and probably looking at it as a game. And I enjoy when other people do well and win and have fun. That's my main interest. It was my main interest too to get as many girls over here as possible, and I succeeded. It's 28. It's the largest women's world championships for the past 10 years, I guess. And so far, everybody is happy and healthy and really enjoying the flying. So that's the main goal.
And nobody's enjoying the flying more than Great Britain's Kathleen Rigg, who's making a comeback to international competition. Six times national champion, Kath's first flight back in the big time has taken her 157 points clear at the top of the leaderboard.
I stopped to have a baby, and I didn't think I'd come back. I didn't think I'd want to, really, because I sort of had enough of it after 16 years. But last summer, I sort of got the bug again, and thought, well, you know, maybe I'll give it a go. And then they organised this Worlds here at Monte Cucu, and it's a really nice place to fly, Monte Cucu. So, oh, well, you know, maybe I'll come and fly it in the Worlds again, because it's such a nice place. But I've had almost no flying for the last 5 years, like 20 hours a year since my son was born. And I didn't fly for 6 months over the winter. And before I came here, I think I had maybe 12 hours this year. And so I didn't expect to be doing as well, really.
So the World Championship has a clear leader, but there are many more tasks to come.
The tasks are set each day according to the weather conditions, and the general idea is to fly a cross-country distance, usually somewhere about 50 or 60 miles minimum, anything up to 120 miles sometimes, as efficiently as you can, and that means as quickly as you can. So they take off, they have some time to establish height in the air, and in these days we use GPS for verifying all the flights. So after they've had perhaps 3/4 of an hour to make as much height as they reasonably can, they fly across a imaginary start line, which is recorded on the GPS. And away they go, searching for a lift all the way from one cloud to another, from one mountaintop to another, until they've gone around the course and hopefully arrive in the goal, back again close to Sigillo and Monte Cuckoo. And then the traces from the GPSs are all downloaded, and the scores worked out from that.
And the scores are changing fast. The next three tasks are won by the world champion, Karina Schwiegershausen. But she's still only second, 104 points behind Kath Rigg.
I try not to fall into the pressure game and just really look at it as a game. And it'll be great to win again. But if not, I'm really happy how things went this week. And the Italians are great organizers. It's been a really good place for the worlds over here.
Task 5 will take the women from Monte Cuckoo due west of Gubbio before heading south to Fossato di Vico and Branca Castle, a flight of 64.5 kilometres.
Well, you're always a bit nervous when you take off, but you just have to go up there and do your best and keep an eye on them and take your chances when you can.
Goal is in the sky over Sigillo. Landing is in a field on the outskirts of the town. And there's a surprise in store. The Russian pilot, Natalia Petrova, who's been flying us, has a narrow lead over France's former world champion, Françoise Dieuzide. At touchdown, it's Natalia by just a few seconds.
In the distance, I saw another pilot before me. I don't, maybe three, four. Very good for me, what I first, yes!
Very good fly. The clouds are very high, many thermic, and good job and good play.
Landing third is the world champion.
Today it was a lovely race because cloud base was much higher than all the days before. I went up to 3,000 meters and really enjoyed the race today because at that altitude you can go very far before you need to catch the next thermal.
And with Kathleen landing back in ninth, the points look like this. For the first time, Karina Schwiegershausen has the lead. Kath Rigg slips to second. Françoise Dieuzide has moved up to third with Switzerland's Carol Tobler and Natalia Petrova of Russia leading the chasing pack. So what makes a winner?
Talent, experience, to watch for little things like clouds or birds or other pilots, and to learn, always be open to learn something new.
I think the level of the woman become better, and to this championship, it's nice because we have young pilot, 20, 24. It's good. The new generation come. I'm happy.
Not everyone is chasing gold and glory. Take Australia's Birgit Svens. She's been flying all her life, some life. She's 63 years old, still competing, still in love with hang gliding.
I'm near the retirement age, can you believe it? Depends on which country you are in, though. No, I am, but I don't feel it, though.
And what did the girls say to you? I mean, how do they treat you as a...
Oh, I'm just like one of the others. I don't get the feeling that I'm old.
Yeah. The pressure is high, is 117, but we have some westerly unstable infiltration of air from west, and it can cause the formation of big clouds and maybe thunderstorm in the afternoon.
It's great because the top four or five, all the points closed up yesterday, so it's going to be lots of fun the next 2 days.
And you're chasing gold, silver today?
Perhaps, we see. I just think to fly and have enjoy today. Just. I hope a good day.
Maybe I can quote an old friend of mine who was a three-time world hang gliding champion. He said, get high, stay high, fly fast. And I'll try that.
There's one more surprise to come from Sigillo as Laura Bazan from Argentina flies higher and longer than anyone. Just as well, we're flying with her.
First time I win a day in my life, so I'm happy.
What's the secret?
Just to stay high and being relaxed. As soon as we push hard, something is, it doesn't work. And today was cool, relaxed, high, and not in a hurry. And as soon as I made the cloud base, that was it, all the time high.
But it's which of the front runners that lands first that really counts. And out from the sky drops the world champion. The crown, the record, must surely be on its way to Germany.
I think today I made quite a few points on the second and third because I landed before Françoise and Kathleen isn't even in goal yet. I haven't seen her anywhere in the air today. So I think tomorrow I can be even calmer than today.
Natalia Petrova lands next, and right behind her is Françoise Dizide. But Catherick's dream comeback has been blown off course.
I got put on the ground by a massive thunderstorm. And just as I was with Jamie, the American girl, just as we were gliding to the turn point, right at the furthest one away, we started feeling rain on top of our sail and everything was in shade. And we were a bit low and there was no way to find any lift. So we just peeled off and went and landed in a nice field. And then the heavens opened and we were packed up in the rain. And then we're in the middle of this field and it was just torrential for an hour and a half. And thunder like I've never heard. The thunder was so loud at one point that Jamie and I jumped in our skin and screaming.
And the threat of thunder puts paid to the last day's flight. So it's gold and a record fourth title for Karina Schwiegershausen of Germany. Françoise Dizide takes silver with Kath Rigg third.
Yes, yes, bronze medal. So I did it. One way or another, I got a medal.
I'm just overwhelmed. It's a very emotional moment to be here and having won the fourth time. It's just way above my head. It's great.
We had perfect weather here. We had very, very good pilots. It was a safe competition. Everybody was flying very safe. And the organization was perfect. And it was, for me, it was a pleasure and an honor to work with these people.
It's a win for Germany too in the team competition with Russia second and Japan third. But it's the 11th FAI Women's World Hang Gliding Championship that has really struck gold in Italy.
It was more about having this meet organized again and encouraging more and more women into the sport and having fun in this competition. And we succeeded big time there. Eating just about flying, you're in the air all day. It's a beautiful sport. I can warmly recommend it to all the women in the world.